Hi, and welcome to On Two Wheels. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the dashboard and the electrical system that I have in mind for my DRZ Rally project. I'll show you how I plan the wiring and some of the accessories I've bought already. And I'd also like to pick your brain to see what ideas you have about this. And some of you might have done this before, so I'd love to get your input on this. At the same time, if I'm doing something wrong, I'd love to hear that too. So stay tuned. So as you know, I started building a rally kit for my DRZ400. So that means I'm building a navigation tower, a windshield, a dashboard, and some additional electrical accessories to make the bike a bit more exciting. As you know, I've been doing this with my friend Davin. And right now, Davin has received all the brackets from the fabricator, which means we've got all the panels and bolts ready to fit onto the bike. So he's assembled one on his bike already. And that looks amazing. He's tested it. It works great, is really stable and does the job really well. But because Davin lives too far away, I can't go and collect my parts from him. If you want to see the rally project right from the beginning, I'm going to add a link to the first video so that you can see how the project started, what parts I've already designed and what modifications I've already done. And also please like this video because it really goes a long way. If you are new to On Two Wheels, please make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the latest notifications. So right now we're in stage 4 lockdown. The only thing I can do is do more planning. So what I've been doing is looking online, doing some research, and I've found all the electrical accessories that I want on the rally tower and I've been buying it. So every other day I get a shipment or a package in the mail with some items. So in this video, I'll show you exactly what I've planned to do with the wiring. And then I'll show you the different accessories I've bought. So let's get started. So before everything, I need to plan my electrical diagram, and that's where high school electronics came in useful. So this is the basic circuit diagram I've got planned. Here we have the 12 volt battery, and right next to the battery, I'm going to add a large fuse. So this is pretty much going to be the fail safe in case something goes wrong. And this makes sure that if the wire is damaged at any point along the bike, this fuse will blow and make sure that it doesn't cause any damage. And right after the fuse, I'll be adding a relay. So what the relay does is that it makes sure that the current flows only when there is a trigger and only when there is a live supply to the bike. So to get that live supply, I'm going to tap into the tail light. So what this means is that when the ignition key is on, there's going to be electricity going to the tail light, and I'm going to tap into that and make sure that that triggers the relay to power the rest of the dashboard. Soon after the relay, I'll have another master switch. And this master switch is so that I can turn all the accessories off. And after the master switch, I have a fuse box. So the fuse box is going to have individual fuses to the different accessories. And the accessories I have in mind are a couple of daytime running lights. So this is more a cosmetic thing and I haven't really found the lights for that yet. So I'm working on this. I then also have a USB outlet. So this USB outlet is to essentially plug in a phone or a GPS unit and charge it while the bike is running. Then I also plan to have grip warmers. So this is something that's just an additional luxury. And I want the switch to be on the dashboard as well. So a lot of the grip warmers I've seen, and even the one I bought online, happens to come with the switch, but an additional switch wouldn't hurt. There's another additional 12 volt line for an emergency. I want to modify the headlights. So right now on the DRZ, the lights always have a power supply, and the toggle switch on the handlebar essentially switches it between high and low beam. So this is pretty okay and I'm happy with that. But what I do want to have is a switch to turn everything off in case I don't want to drain the battery. So for example, I'm doing some hard tracks and the bike might end up stalling all the time. I might need to turn off the headlights just so that I conserve battery. So this will pretty much let me do that. So this is another switch, and all of these switches will go right back to the battery's neutral terminal. So this fuse box you see is a box which has individual fuses, but for diagram purposes, I've added a single fuse box, and the switches will be individual switches. So let's start looking at the different items. First, I've got a headlight here. So this headlight I'm not going to be using, but I thought I'll show you nonetheless. I got this online. So this is a pretty interesting headlight. It's got a high beam, a low beam, as well as two daytime running lights, as well as a halo. So it looked pretty nice online, and the reason I wanted this was because I wanted to have a low energy consumption daylight running light as opposed to using the low beam on the bike all the time. This was going to be used in my initial design, but since I started working with Devin, we decided to go with a much leaner look, and Devin found some amazing lights, so I won't be using this. So while I'm showing you things that I'm not going to use, I'll show you something else that I bought. So I bought these top switches for the lights, which are normally used on car interiors. So these switches are neat because they tell you exactly what the switch is for. And the simple press motion is quite good because if you're wearing gloves, you don't want to be fiddling with tiny little switches. It's supposed to be watertight, but I'll stick to a more durable switch. So another thing that I bought were these male and female H4 bulb adapters. So that's because I didn't want to cut the main wire harness that was providing power to the headlight. So I figured if I get an adapter that looks just like a headlight or a bulb, I could just plug it in and it would solve my problem. So I'll be using this. So this is the fuse holder for the fuse that will be going right next to the battery. Again, I made sure that I got fuser electrical connectors and plugs that happen to be watertight, because at some point the bike is going to be submerged in water and I don't want everything just shutting down because it got water in it. So next I have the relay for the whole tower and the electric system. So it's a fairly straightforward relay and it comes with all the plugs and the clips that's necessary. So again, something that's watertight. Going watertight is always important, especially on a bike. And next I have the fuse box. So this is actually quite nice. I'm really impressed with it. So this fuse box also acts as a sort of a distribution box. So the main line from the battery can go connect right into this. And you've got six different outlets and each of them can have individual fuses. And the return line can come and connect back onto a single common negative point, which can then flow back into the battery. So this looks nice and it's got a pretty solid feel. And it's always good to have fuses that are easily visible because you don't want to have to troubleshoot a bike in the middle of the bush. The cover has a clear section which lets you see individual fuses and the bulbs to make sure that they all have their own power supply. Next, we have the fuses for the fuse box, a couple of screws that came with it, and oh yeah, so this is just some shrink wrap just to make sure that there's no exposed wires and that everything is properly covered. What else do I have? This happens to be, oh, so throughout the bike we are bound to have different wires that need to connect, and rather than just solder the wires and wrap them with tape, I decided to use clips that have decent protection and won't cause anything to short circuit. It's a pretty neat design as well. So I bought a little extra just in case. So next I have my USB outlet. You've got two lines out, both 2.1 amperes. This is going to be very useful, especially if I'm using a GPS or a phone on the ride. And the good thing is it's got a rubber cover, which pretty much seals the outlet when it's not being used. It also keeps dust and dirt from going into this. Last but not least, I have my switches. So these switches are something that I am really, really excited about. They happen to be toggle switches. Unlike little plastic button switches, these are very retro style toggle switches, which are pretty easy to use if you're wearing gloves, because all you need is just a single toggle motion and it's hard to explain, but the feel, it's a very solid switch and it's got a very satisfying click to it. So I'm going to be using a series of these. I bought about 5 switches, even though I need only 3. The switches are great, but I also want to make sure that they are actually powered. So to help me identify when a particular line has, I'll be adding LED bulbs, which will indicate if there's power. So it's a very basic bulb. So it's essentially an LED bulb with a holder and some wires connected. It comes in different colors. So I've got yellow, red, green, white, and blue. So this will also help me identify the different accessories that are on the bikes. So this means I should use a single color of wire and bulb for a single accessory, just so that it's easy to identify and more intuitive. And just to make sure that everything is nice and neat, I also bought some self-adhesive ties. So essentially these are Velcro straps which are smooth on one side with the felt and the little hooks on the other. So this is going to be helpful when I organize the wires inside the tower. And also if I want to have any removable accessories. So it's just to make sure that the tower is neat. So that's all the accessories I've got right now. The hand grips that I've ordered are still on the way. You'll probably see that on the next video once it's on the bike. So to reach this point, Devin and I had a lot of discussions on how we want our wiring to work. So we won't be using the same setup. So this rally tower setup is a personal choice that I went with. You might have different options. In fact, Devin himself has a different setup on his bike. So when we meet up, I'll show you his bike as well. So this is the first time I'm actually building a rally tower or adding this many electrical components to a bike. So I'd like to hear your input on what I have in mind. And at the same time, if I'm doing something wrong, please let me know. And if you have any suggestions, I'm definitely open for it, because it's better to get all of this planned out right now rather than wait till I've built everything and then have to rewire things. So I also had another slightly simpler version of the whole rally setup, which was essentially going to be a plug and play. So all the accessories would be powered literally from the headlights power supply. So the stock DRZ headlight is a 55 or 65 watt bulb, but with the rally tower, we'll be consuming much less, which means there's plenty of electricity to go around for other accessories. So that would mean we could plug the whole tower in to where the headlight goes and power all the accessories. The good thing there is it becomes a much simpler approach, but this also means I need to add a few new electronic components. For example, a couple of diodes, because the power supply going to the headlights are going to one or the other of the lights. So to get an uninterrupted power supply, we need to make sure that we tap into either of these. And because this wire comes out of the handlebar, and again, I don't want to meddle with or damage the main wire harness. So what we would need to do is add a couple of diodes and then redirect it to the fuse box. And being a bit ambitious, I was thinking maybe even add a capacitor, just so that for that brief moment that the power supply switches from high beam to low beam, fuse box gets an uninterrupted current. So this is another idea. And again, like I said, it just plugs straight into the main harness and there's very little work you need to do. So I'd love to hear everyone's ideas on how I should proceed with this. So with lockdown, this project has been going a lot slower than I had initially planned. It is what it is. There's nothing we could do about it, but all we can do is make the best of it and hope that once we come out of lockdown, the bikes are ready and we can go enjoy the outdoors. If you found this video interesting, please remember to give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to On Two Wheels and hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications.